Hello beautiful people, it's Yabo. If this is your first time of watching my video, you're welcome to my channel. And if you're a returning subscriber, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for stopping by. Yeah, I know it's been a while. I'm so sorry it took me some time to come back, but I'm back and I'm going to be consistent again. We are fully back. But before I continue this video or start this video, I would like to say a very huge thank you to everyone. Last month was really cool. I actually saw a big progress and I really want to say thank you so much. And if you are yet to subscribe, if you are yet to catch up on other videos, you should catch up because you guys definitely like something, obviously. And please, just like my friend would say, please tell your friend to watch this video. And yeah, let's just progress together. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about why we have two Congo countries. Have you ever thought of it? Okay, why do we have the Democratic Republic of Congo and why do we have the Republic of Congo? What's the difference? Why do we have two Congo countries? Why? But you don't need to worry. I'm going to be talking about it in today's video. Democratic Republic of Congo is larger than the Republic of Congo. The Democratic Republic of Congo has its capital being referred to as Kinshasa, and the Republic of Congo has its capital being referred to as Brazzaville. Though these two countries are culturally and historically related, but they differ politically and geographically. Another thing I would like to point out and just clarify is the term Congo. The term Congo was gotten from the Bakongo people of the Bantu tribe. Now, this set of people actually occupied the land from 12th century. And as at 15th century, they adopted a centralized system of government. Yes, these two nations actually were together and they adopted a centralized system of government. But that didn't last for too long because, you know, after this scramble for Africa regime came up and a lot of things were happening in the Berlin Conference. But yes, even though these two countries are still in Central Africa, but they are separated by the Congo River and also their colonial history. Now, their colonial history prompted the separation. So not how long after these people adopted their centralized system of government, we all know the term scramble for Africa, right? It is no doubt that the way most African countries are right now, I mean, their colonial history and the system of government most of the African countries adopted can actually, we can see that it is being influenced with the colonial background. And so also is it for the Bakongo people that are today referred to as the Democratic Republic of Congo and the Republic of Congo. Yeah. So after the Berlin Conference that lasted from November 1884 to 1885, this nation were divided under two controls, the Belgian control and the French control. Now, one thing I can actually depict from this thing is that if this nation were given to just one control, probably we would not have two Congo countries. But because, you know, it is two different political power, nobody wants to bow down for one person and everybody would just want to adopt their own system of government. So therefore, they have two nations. The larger part of the land was given to King Leopold II of Belgium, and he ironically named the state Congo Free State. And I said ironically because during his regime, the people actually went through a lot of inhuman thing, and he was just actually ruling for his own selfish interest. But I'm not going to be talking about the whole story today. Probably, I don't know if I will be talking about it, I would make reference to this video. But Congo Free State was just the whole mess actually. because a lot of things just happened, a lot of inhuman thing. But because of his inhuman act, in 1908, the Belgium government actually regained this land and it became the Belgium government's property. On the other hand, the French control was also given the smaller part of the land. And just like the Belgian have, in 1960, parts that was under the French control, which was referred to as French Congo, was actually named the Republic of Congo. And also in 1960, the one under Belgian control was referred to as Democratic Republic of Congo. Until date, yeah, that's how they have been called. And that was actually the main reason why we have two Congo countries. It was because of their difference in the colonial history. If probably, like I said, they were under maybe the Belgian control, it would have just been one country. And if it had been under the French control, it could have just been one country. But because it was, the land was divided under two different political powers, we have two different countries. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. But still, these two countries are the same. They are people that hailed from the Bakongo people. We all know that now. And if you don't know that before, you know that now. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'll see you in my next video. Please do not forget to subscribe. Give this video a thumbs up. And you should follow me on Instagram and on Twitter. It's _Iyabo. And I really hope you guys enjoy it. I love you. And if you have any idea or you want me to talk about any other topic, just put it down in the comment section. I love you and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.